you know, I'm just so glad to be able to be here at Coco Hall. Hopefully you've been enjoying some great seminars and some great people. I'm seeing Wendy, I know Liana's coming up, but we're going to try to fix your life before that. But I see all these great demons in here. My goodness, you know, just to be a man speaking of women's empowerment, Expo is really an honor for me. I see all this beautiful estrogen in the place. All these demons. If you a diva, just say, yeah. All these divas, and really I say divas because I define it as divinely inspired, virtuous, or victorious accomplices. I'm going to say that again. So nice, I'm going to say it twice. Divinely inspired, victorious, accomplished sisters. And really, y'all Detroit's inspired, victorious, accomplished sisters. Because y'all are from near and far. And so it's just a wonderful opportunity to be able to be here. And you know, there's a poignant quote that suggests no nation can rise higher than its women. And so when you empower women, when we empower you all as great CEOs, as entrepreneurs, as individuals who are pertinent in business and being able to heal yourself from within, because I believe you can't begin to look for someone new until you heal from the old ways of past. And so today we're going to share a little bit, and I'm from Detroit. I'm an East Side rider, y'all. I'm from the East Side. Where my East Side folks at? Straight up, don't let the smooth suit.
Don't let
the smooth take school. So I'm from Warren and kind of represent all. Straight up. So, you know, like they say, run up, you get done up. Yeah, run up, and we gonna see. Yeah, that's what you said. But, you know, I'm a Detroiter, and of course, I'm an author. I've got some books here that I'm gonna share about a little bit. I'm working as a professor at Marygrove College, but I also have a powerful story as well of overcoming stage 4 cancer. So that's another reason why I'm wearing pink today, too, because we're definitely survivors, and you can. And I would say, really the genesis of speaking about relationships and you developing yourself and understanding your worth and knowing yourself is really you being able to realize your value. And I think that's really the genesis of the substratum, the foundation of really what we want to kind of share about today. One of the reasons why I wrote my book, Heal Your Heart, is my fifth book, but it's one of my most personal books because really the book is an ode to women who stole the virtues and values of what women bring to society. And really, I think more than any other time, we have to stand up as men to defend, really to have the backs of our women. Just last month, five women outside of Sandra Bland were killed in jail. And so to bring that to the conscience and make that aware and really just to defend and hold up and extol the virtues and values of what women bring, them understanding their value, you knowing your worth, you understanding that you are really worth loving. You have something that is of significance and of value, and you have a jewel that's on the inside of you. Everybody, I like to say, is a red box and a gold bulb. You're a gift to the world. And you have to realize that gift and that value and nurture that self. Nurture who you are on the inside. And really just to grow through negativity. Grow through relationships. I know, how many people saw the new movie Straight Outta Compton? Yeah, but if not, some people on their way, I haven't seen it either. I'm literally straight out of Texas, coming from Texas yesterday. But some of us are going to be straight out of bad relationships, straight out of negativity, straight out of getting over certain things that have been holding and hanging on to us. And so, you know, I'd like to say it this way. If people aren't adding to your life, life is simple math. If people aren't adding to your life, you have to do some simple math and subtract them from your life. Because where God has for you and where he's trying to take you and what you have for your destiny, really you can't allow anybody to get in the way of it. And oftentimes we allow ourselves to get in our own way. I really don't think you can talk about healing if you haven't been hurt. You can't talk about breakthrough if you haven't been broken. And the whole aspect of really you loving yourself and seeing your worth is very unique and significant. Sometimes we have to change our vision about ourselves and where we have come from to realize that everything that we've been through doesn't define us, but it refines us to where we can really, you know, use our tests, our testimony, our miseries, ministry, our message, the message, your stumbling block is your stepping stone. And so oftentimes, a lot of times people come into relationships more so looking to receive than to give. And really, I think you have to approach a relationship as a waiter or a waitress rather than a customer. because oftentimes when we come in receiving, or looking to receive, or and oftentimes in general, this is what men do. A lot of times men, we come into relationships and we come to show our love. And we wind up wondering why the woman left and was only specifically just focused on our money, but that's all we had to show. Women come in oftentimes, you know, showing their body. Low and high, y'all know how it is. You know, thinking that, these legs, these thighs, these hips are going Popeyes. Like you ain't KFC, you ain't Chicken Shack, you ain't none of that. But when you begin to show who you are, you know, if he's more focused on your behind than your mind, something's wrong. And how can I tell if that is significant? What is he placing more of an emphasis on? You never have to chase a man if you have a plan. Because when you begin to chase your purpose and you begin to chase your plan, the right man is going to chase you. I like to say, women, you're always going to be tired if you chase a man. You were designed to strut in heels. You weren't designed to run after him in gym shoes. If you're running after him, you're going to have to show up through some running to keep him. You know, but when you begin to show your virtue and your value and your significance, it's not necessarily about you being high and mighty and haughty and you being, super pious and this, that, and the other, but you just understand that your who you are is like a fragrance to a room. You change the atmosphere based on your attitude, and your attitude determines your attitude. Sometimes y'all can be hard to approach, ladies. My goodness. I'll make it hard for a brother. A little sometimes, maybe y'all ain't Miss Hayes, but sometimes brother just trying to say hello and y'all mean money. You know, just because you have been bruised doesn't mean you've been broken. You have the opportunity to break through. And so taking the time to nurture and to value yourself and to see that I have something that's significant in me, on me. You know, it's not about me wearing St. John, it ain't about me having a Louis Vuitton account, it ain't about you having a Fendi bag and you and all that other stuff. It's about you understanding what's inside of me is greater than anything that you can put on me. My value is what is significant, because everybody here is a magnet. You're a magnet for the positive and the negative. You're either repelling the good or the bad. What are you attracting based on your disposition? What type of man are you attracting based on how you dress or how you look? What's your frame of reference in relation to how you think of? What are you attracting based on it? Because oftentimes we're looking on the outside, depending on what he is. Everybody just messed up. Every man is a dog. You know, versus understanding that there's going to be some good and some bad people, but I'm going to overcome that obstacle and I'm going to grow as a result of it. I'm getting better, not bitter. That's what it's